darling, what could you be possibly doing in that bathroom for so long?
Oh, nothing. Just trying to fix up my makeup, love.
Why? It doesn't matter. You still look like the Medusa I married 16 years ago.
I suppose you're right.
Why don't you go make yourself useful and start the caddy?
All right, honey.
William,
Dad,
come here.
Yes, Daddy.
Kitty, you look like a mess. Let me fix your tie.
Daddy, why? Redneck folk. Sen, Laverne is a very key role in my corporation. She's been there since the beginning. And I think it'd only be fair to take her family out to a nice dinner.
But, Daddy, I see that Robbie Bobby street urchin every day at school, playing farting contests with your boys. I mean, how important can this Laverne be if she names her child two first names? Two of the same first name.
Son, it's only fair to get to know the co-worker that's dear to my heart.
I suppose, Daddy.
Don't worry, son. They can't be that bad.
Basket full of chicken and a big...
You can't sing, but
her hair reminds me of a warm spring sun.
Well, where on earth did you get that interesting jacket?
And what would you ladies and gentlemen like to drink?
Yes, my wife and I would like a Chardonnay, and the child here would like a glass of sparkling cider.
And also have the Chardonnay as well, too, please.
Sprite. Okay, me and Robbie Bobby will have the Sprite.
I'm sorry, sir, we do not serve Sprite here.
Well, that's cool, man. So you're Mrs. Fontu.
No, sir, you do not understand. We do not serve fountain drinks.
Now, why would you serve drinks out of a fountain? That's just plain stupid and unsanitary.
George, you'll just have the water.
Very well.
Yes, I have this odd feeling that I've seen you somewhere before.
Oh, well, I was on a hit show.
Really? What was that?
I was on Cops.
Oh, you're a cop! Everybody loves a man in uniform.
Jenny, don't.
Sorry, Cuckoo better be here, hasn't had a meds today.
May I ask you what you were on that for?
Well, it was really just a misunderstanding. I didn't know it was indecent exposure.
George! Oh! Your high pitch room last week.
Yes, me, Donald Trump, and Mr. Gates all went up to my cabin up north and did some fishing. It was really a mesmerizing experience.
You know, I spent the night at George Strait's house once.
Oh, really? What was he like?
Well, he was really nice after the cops showed up. But now I'm not allowed within 1,000 feet of him or his family.
Here are your drinks. And are you ladies and gentlemen ready to order?
Yes. I will have the beef Wellington with a side of baked vegetables, please. Baked vegetables.
Yes, and I should have the scallops.
Jenny, don't you think that's a little, you know, fattening? I mean, it's not like you need any more.
How's your ride?
I'll have risotto, but you know, just a pinch of rosemary, it really brings out the flavor.
Bobby, Bobby, and I will be out deep. Chicken medallion with a side of mashed potatoes.
And for you, sir?
Oh, I'll have the... the filet mignon.
You mean the filet mignon, sir?
Are you okay, boy? Man, you sound like you got peanut butter in your mouth or something.
No, Georgia boy, that's what the food's called. That's what the food's called. Oh, what's wrong with him, Daddy?
George, why don't you tell Cornelius what you do for a living?
Oh, well, my hobby's hot dog eating contest. But my real job's in the sanitation department.
Oh, really? In what parts?
Well, in layman's terms, I pump the porta potties at construction sites.
Ew, that's disgusting!
That is interesting. Yeah, so I guess you can call me a brown noser sort
of. It's inappropriate for dinner conversation!
Be a little civilized here, George!
Okay, hey, Corny, you mind if I call you Corny? Well, great. What do you do for a living?
Well, when I'm not at the office, I like to play cricket.
Oh man, you must not have a lot of friends if you play with crickets.
It's a game, kind of like baseball. Do you understand?
No, you don't understand?
It's okay, George. I didn't know what cricket was for the longest time.
Shirley, that's because you don't really understand much in life.
That's what happens when you stay at home all day and watch Oprah.
Well, we are going to wash up before supper. Come on. No.
Darling, how can you let that man talk to you like that?
I mean, he takes care of me, so dealing with that is sort of what I have to deal with.
Well, if I were you, I would demand some more respect.
You're right.
I know I usually am.
We have to leave Cornelius.
I didn't say that.
George, no, you're right. It's the only way I'll get the respect I deserve.
Well, we were absolutely silent. Where did we leave off last?
I believe we were talking about hobbies.
Oh, yes. What do you like to do on your spare time?
Well, I watch a lot of NASCAR.
Woo! You're all the way to Daytona.
Yo! Shake it, mate. Well, to be completely honest with you, George, I think that NASCAR is the most pointless sport in the world.
Yes, yes, yes. What's the point of watching a bunch of loud vehicles making a bunch of left turns?
You're lucky we don't have oil. I had a karate tap you in the throat. Whoop-a!
Sun in the sky, you know how I feel. Breeze drifting on by, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life.
Congratulations.
had enough money to shop at Goodwill. I'm sorry I don't go play for crickets or camp with Donald Duck. But I'm not going to be sorry for Lily. Because that's the one thing that I have that they don't. You can't buy love. It's something that you get when you only find that one special person. It makes you want to take him out to fancy places, to surf